guys, it's Judy here with My Life as Geek Guy, and welcome to today's video. I'm very excited to be bringing this video to you because I created a new tag. I did a bit of a search on YouTube, and as far as I'm aware, no one has yet created this tag called 10 Things No One Tells You About Being a YouTuber. Now, I know there may already be some tags out there that have similar questions, but I compiled these 10 questions with the thought of encouraging people who are new on YouTube, who are trying to create a channel, who are trying to build on it and become discovered. These are questions that I wanted to answer and tell you guys on what it really takes to become a YouTuber and how to almost kind of claw your way to the top on this platform. Now, I'm not in any way, shape, or form saying that I'm already at the top. In fact, I'm at the bottom of the bottom. Maybe not quite. I've just like reached up a 0.1%. I'm almost at 3,000 subscribers, you guys. I cannot believe that I'm almost at 3,000 subscribers, but you know, miracles do happen. Thank you. Thank you. Really thankful for every single one of you who are subscribed and who have helped me get to the point where I am right now. And I just wanted to create this tag. I've been wanting to create a tag for a while, but I wasn't really inspired until I really sat down and thought about these 10 questions. So without further ado, I bring to you guys 10 things that no one tells you about being a YouTuber. Okay, so question number one, how long did it take you to reach 1,000 subscribers? I created this question because it takes different amounts of time for literally everybody. Everyone has their own different journey on YouTube. For me, it took me almost a year, maybe I think it was 10 months to reach 1,000 subscribers. At that point, I was going gung-ho with uploads. That was literally all I was doing in my spare time. I am also working a full-time job as well. Yeah, it took me almost a year to reach 1,000 subscribers. So on YouTube guidelines, you need to reach 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time in order to be able to monetize your videos, like have the ads play on them. And so it was a real goal for me to reach 1,000 subscribers and 4,000 hours of watch time. I reached 4,000 hours of watch time a little bit before the 1,000 subscribers. And then as soon as I reached 1,000 subscribers, that was it. I've reached my goal. I was really, really thankful. And then from memory, I think it took about a week to 2 weeks for YouTube to review my channel and have me given the little check mark for being able to monetize my videos. The question number two is, how many videos a week do you put out, and why did you choose that number of videos? So when I first started my YouTube channel, I was uploading 3 videos every single week, and I continued on that self-imposed schedule for over a year. I think it was almost 2 years that I was doing that. The second year was very difficult for me in my personal life in general, but I struggled through. I felt like the commitment of 3 videos a week is what really kept me going through that difficult time. It gave me something to get up for in the morning. It gave me purpose. It gave me something to look forward to. And so I continued on with 3 videos a week for almost 2 years. Towards the end of the second year on my YouTube channel, I found that I was burning out. It was a really, really big commitment for me. So for a couple months, I went down to 2 videos a week. That still ended up being a lot. My job became even more demanding of me. And so now at this point, I'm down to 1 video a week, and I'm okay with that. I find that I'm much more able to manage it. There's a lot of other things going on in my life right now. And so 1 video a week for me, I find is a good number. I'm able to focus on batch filming videos, which means if I can sit down and record 4 videos in 1 day in a filming session, it means that's 4 videos and it's a month's worth of videos for me. And I'm able to manage that on top of my normal life, my full-time job, renovating my house at the same time. So that's the journey of number of videos I put out every single week from when I started my YouTube channel till now. Question number 3, how many hours a week do you spend on your YouTube channel? When I first started my YouTube channel, I think I was spending at least maybe 16 hours a week, about 16 to 20 hours on average. It depends on what days I filmed, what kind of editing process I did on the actual video. I find that editing videos takes a whole lot more time than actually filming them. The preparation for the videos as well, I need to research, I need to figure out what videos are actually being searched, what keywords are actually being searched so that I actually have a chance of my video being seen. And so it's more than just the process of filming a video and putting it up on the internet. that it's a process of research, filming, editing, thumbnails, uploading, filling in the description, filling in the tags, and then optimizing the video. So when I first started my channel, I think just to get the kickstart, have it up and running, I was spending close to 20 hours every week on top of my full-time job on my YouTube channel. Now I think I spend about maybe 8 hours every single week on average, just being able to create one video and put it out every single Sunday. Question number four, how do you come up with YouTube ideas? So I find that I am generally quite inspired by watching other YouTubers. I don't copy. It's like me looking at a recipe. I never ever follow recipes. I do look at recipes to be inspired. Looking at recipes kind of inspires me to create something else. It almost completely different, but kind of inspired by. So that's almost the same way that I think when it comes to finding out ideas that I want to create for YouTube. I might watch another creator's video and think, oh, that's a really good idea, and it inspires me to create something else and put my own spin on it. I find the video ideas that more popular YouTubers are using are videos that maybe everyone else are creating as well. And so the chances of my video being seen isn't very high. And so I still have to take the idea and sort of like niche it down even more for me, because not many people are going to see my video if it's so inundated by the more bigger and popular videos on algorithm pushing down my video. And so I have to really think about it. It's more than just being like, oh, I want to film that and I want to put it on the internet. If I'm going to spend 8 hours creating one video, I want to make sure that it's at least going to be seen. So another way that I come up with video ideas is that I think of something that I want to create, because you still got to be inspired and motivated with creativity to create it. Like, do you actually want to create that video? And then I go onto YouTube and I use the YouTube extension tools, vidIQ and TubeBuddy, to see if the keywords of that video that I want to create, like what the title is going to be, I type it in and see if the keywords in that title is actually being searched and if it has actually any chance of being seen on the platform and what my chances are compared to the competition that is out there. So there's a lot of research and backtracking before you can actually press record. There's a lot of research that needs to go into it. There's a lot of thought and there's a lot of figuring out before you actually create that video if you actually should spend the time creating that video, because there's nothing more frustrating than creating a video and thinking it's gonna be so great and then you put it up and you get maybe like 10 views. You feel me? You feel me? So there's a lot of thought that needs to go into a video idea before you can create it. Another thing that I do for ideas on what videos to create is I go on the search bar on YouTube, and whenever you type in there and the suggestions that come up, those are things that people are searching. If you are a makeup channel like I am, I type in there how to such and such and it'll come up with suggested, and it'll come up with suggested video titles. Now those video titles are things that people are actually searching, and so I gain inspiration from those suggested things that come up to create my own video, because I know people are searching it and I know that I have a chance at getting my video up there in search results. Question number five, how did you come up with your channel name? So when I was thinking about my channel name, the word geek eye, it's a Filipino slang word. When I chose that name to be part of my channel name, I was thinking that I would more target Filipino audiences. I thought that with the word geek eye, Filipino audiences would be more attracted to my channel and hence watch my videos. Turns out it's not really working out that way. The majority of my audience are not Filipino. I have a lot of people watching from the Philippines, my analytics tell me, but I'm finding that the word geek eye is probably more of people think it's my actual name. I did choose that word because I think it's cute. The word geek eye is a Filipino slang word for someone who likes makeup, beauty, and fashion, and so I thought it was really cute to maybe try and integrate it into my channel name. However, almost three years later after creating my channel, I realized that maybe it's not the best channel name for me to have. Also, what I'm putting to you guys in this video is if you think maybe I should change my channel name. Should I keep it as Life as Geek Eye, or should I change it to Judy O'Meara, which is essentially what my, that's what my name is. Judy is a nickname. So should I change my channel name to Judy O'Meara or keep it as Life as Geek Eye? Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think. Question number six, have you ever felt like giving up on YouTube? Yes, Many times, many times. I've burned out a couple times, especially during the time where I was putting out 3 videos every single week. If you really think about it, that is a lot. That's a lot of videos. And there was a time and place for that. I feel like it was when I was trying to get traction on my channel and get it up and running. It was a good time to put out 3 videos a week. Now I'm comfortable with just 1. Sure, my watch time and my views have gone downhill, but you know what? Something's gotta give. In my life, I just need to find a balance between work and home and life and YouTube and all of that. So yes, definitely, there have been times that I felt like giving up on my YouTube channel, but what remedied that for me was being able to find that balance and being able to let go of the commitment of 3 videos a week. I felt like a little bit of a loser or a quitter when I did that, but then I realized that the 3 videos a week was a self-imposed schedule. No one was forcing me to put out that many videos a week, and in the process, I was just burning myself out. And so to remedy the feeling of giving up on YouTube, I went down to 1 video a week. That was incredibly helpful for me in my personal life, my mental health, and just everything in general. And also part of helping me keep on keeping on with the YouTube is just remembering the why. So ultimately, in a few years from now, I'm hoping that I can be a stay-at-home mom. At the same time, I don't want to have to leave the full earning the bread and butter to my husband. I want to still be able to create some income from home. And so that's why I created my YouTube channel 3 years ago, because I had the vision. I had the bigger picture in mind. I had a long-term vision in mind. And so I'm gonna keep on keeping on, and hopefully this becomes something, you know? 3 years later, after I created my YouTube channel, is it 3 years? Is it 3 years? I think it's 3 years, almost 3 years after I created my YouTube channel. Here I am, still going, almost at 3,000 subscribers. I think that's a pretty good effort, I guess. And you know, everyone's saying, oh, it's just gonna take that 1 video to go viral. I have had 1 video go viral, but it's not even about makeup. It's literally on my how to save money video. I've had 1 more video go viral. It's my L'Occitane Immortelle Reset Serum video. That one's reached 20,000 plus views or something like that, but it hasn't really translated into views and subscribers for my channel in a very, very large scale. So I'm still waiting for my channel to blow up, and if it never actually happens, that's okay. Like, I'm just gonna keep on keeping on. If anything, at the moment, the money that YouTube is making me pays for my fuel every month. Question number 7, what inspires you to keep on creating YouTube videos? I kind of answered that question a little bit in the previous question. What inspires me to keep on creating YouTube videos is you guys, literally you guys. The people who comment on every upload that I put up, the people who actually watch my videos, the people who like and share. I know there are those of you who do it. My comments on each video have gone down drastically. It's just not the same like it used to be. I don't know what I'm doing wrong, or maybe people, you know, people move on, and that's okay. But the few people who do still regularly comment on my videos, I really truly appreciate you. I can count on one hand out of the almost 3,000 subscribers, it's those few people that keep inspiring me to create YouTube videos. On top of that, it's also the vision. Like I mentioned before, I have a vision and I have a passion to keep on creating something here on YouTube, something that I can do as a job from home. Maybe later on, maybe I can integrate a little bit more into it. I'm still trying to figure out exactly what I want to create my channel into, but yeah, it's a growth, it's a process, it's a journey, and I'm excited to see where it takes me in a few years from now, maybe 10 years from now. I'll look back and think, wow, I'm so glad I didn't stop creating YouTube videos. You know, you never know. So just keep persevering. That's my motto. Question number 8, what is your least favorite thing about YouTube? My least favorite thing about YouTube is the fact that I need to edit the videos that I put out. I actually don't mind filming videos. I actually find filming videos quite enjoyable. If I could just film a video and it'll find its way onto my channel platform somehow without the whole process of me editing it, that would just be so great. Thank you, thank you. But no, unfortunately, that's just not the way it works. So I film a video, put it on my computer, and I edit it. I generally, on average, spend maybe about 6 to 8 hours editing a video. It takes me that long because, for one, my computer is a little bit slow. For two, my software crashes every so often. And three, I can't concentrate on editing a video for more than maybe 15 minutes at a time. So I need to stop, take a break, watch a bit of Netflix, then come back to it. And so that's why it takes me that long. If I had the ability to solidly concentrate on editing a video, it might take me 4 hours to edit one and get it up. But unfortunately, that's just not the way that I operate. So yeah, editing videos is my least favorite thing about YouTube. Hey guys, Future Editing Me here. While I was editing this video, I realized that I skipped question number 9, which is, what is your favorite thing about YouTube? I've just talked about what my least favorite thing about YouTube was, which is editing video, which is what I'm doing right now, this video that you're watching. But my most favorite thing about YouTube is watching the community growth that we are building here on this platform. So I've made friends on here. There are people who have connected. There are people who message me and say, hey, I'm really enjoying watching your videos. There have been people who message me and be like, hey, I'm stuck at home at the moment due to everything else that's going on, and I'm watching your videos and they're really helping me get through this time. That you make me laugh, you make me smile. And it's things like that, it's comments, it's messages from people, real people like you guys watching, the feedback that you guys give me about my videos. That's probably my most favorite thing about YouTube. And just watching the growth, actually, watching the growth. Like, I know it shouldn't be all about numbers, and it's not all about numbers for me. If I just focused on numbers, I would have given up a long time ago. But what I'm saying is, I really enjoy watching the acceleration of growth of people in this community. Yeah, long story short, it's just the people who make up the Geekai family, you know? It's you guys that are my favorite thing about YouTube. And I'm not just saying this to suck up your backside. It actually legit is my favorite thing about YouTube. So I just want to say thank you. If you're watching this, thank you. I appreciate it. Anybody who thumbs up my videos, who shares, who comments, who likes, any action that you guys make on my channel, honestly, I just want to say thank you. It's because of you that I keep undoing this, really. And yeah, I hope you guys are staying safe, healthy, happy. I don't think I mentioned that in the original video that I'm editing right now, but I just wanted to put a little insert here that I just hope you guys are staying safe, practicing common sense, and staying safe. Love you guys. Oh, I shouldn't touch my face. And last but absolutely not least is, how do you deal with mean comments? I'm very fortunate that I don't get very many, but as the growth on my channel is slowly but surely accelerating, I have found that I've been getting more random mean comments more often in the last 3 months than any other time in the whole life of my channel. Honestly, the mean comments, they don't bother me because I look at the profile of the person who's commented it and I don't recognize the profile. So I know for sure it's not one of my regular subscribers. My regular subscribers, you guys are awesome. They're always very kind and very sweet. You watch my videos, you always comment nice things. I'm really thankful for you. But those few minute percent of people who think it's okay to leave a mean comment, the way that I deal with it is that I kind of laugh. It kind of makes me laugh, just the mean comments. I had someone the other day comment on one of my videos, I think it was a review of some really super expensive product, tell me that I can't believe that you're reviewing this product, it's actually a scam. And I'm just like, okay. Mean comments make me laugh. Even when the comments are like a personal attack on my appearance, I'm not that insecure that it'll ruin me for the rest of the day, or it'll pierce my heart and make me feel like, oh. But no, mean comments, they don't bother me. Maybe I'll change my tune in a few years' time when I'm getting maybe more than 3 mean comments a month. Who knows? Maybe when that time, I'll probably block them before it gets to that point. But you know what? If you get mean comments, just don't let it bother you. You are you. They don't know you. They don't know me. And that's okay. Like, it doesn't affect my life. Mean people don't affect my life. Just deal with it by not dealing with it at all. And, you know, if it makes you feel better, block them. That's okay. Like, I mean, for me, a comment is a comment. A comment is engagement. YouTube still sees that as engagement. So for me, I'm just like, I still got your view, I still got your comment, I still got your engagement. And so for me, even the thumbs down on my YouTube videos, the algorithm still sees that as engagement. So I'm like, yeah, please, thumbs it down all you want. It's better than not thumbsing down or thumbsing up at all. Like, you know, give me some sort of boost in the algorithm, please. Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate your mean comments, appreciate your thumbs down, because it's all one and the same to the YouTube algorithm. And so, that's it for my 10 things no one tells you about being a YouTuber tag. If you are a new YouTuber, or you're someone who's fairly new on the YouTube platform, or fairly small on the YouTube platform, I would love for you to create this tag. Please answer these questions. I'm gonna leave them all listed in the description box down below. Tag someone who you would love to see the answers of, create this tag. And please, it'd be nice if you could credit me in the tag as well. I don't think anyone else has actually created this tag, honestly. If you have, I'm sorry, I did not mean to copy your tag. Again, I know a lot of these questions might be a little bit similar in other tags, but it was me that compiled these 10 questions of 10 things no one tells you about being a YouTuber. I would like to tag a few people to create this video. I'd like to tag Liz Guico, Nona from My So-Called Life, and I would like to tag Brianna from Purple Print Greg. If you guys are watching this video, I tag you. If you want to create it, go on right ahead. Thank you guys for watching this video. Thank you for being here. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up or a thumbs down. Either way, I don't care. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for being here. I really truly appreciate that you've chosen to spend your time here with me today. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. I find that the video ideas that more pop, I find the So yeah, there have been times when I felt like giving up on my YouTube.